Find the antiderivative of x times ln of x dx. When I go ahead and write out my integration by parts formula, I get the antiderivative of u dv equals uv minus the antiderivative of v du. To be able to apply this, I need to take our particular antiderivative and match it up with this. So I need to know what u is, and I need to know what dv is. So in this case, I'm going to choose u to be the ln of x. That means everything else, the x and the dx, have to go with the dv. So dv is equal to x dx. With the u, I'm going to get the du by taking the derivative. And with the dv, I'm going to take the antiderivative to figure out what v is. So let's start by taking u equals ln of x, and let's take its derivative. So du dx, in other words, the derivative of ln of x is 1 over x. And if I multiply both sides by dx, I get that du is equal to 1 over x dx. Now I'm going to go down and take my dv. I'll divide both sides by dx. So that gives me that dv over dx is just x. And the antiderivative of x is x squared over 2. Now that I have my u, my du, my dv, and my v, I can go ahead and put those things into the integration by parts formula. So uv ln of x times x squared over 2 gives me what you see right here, the x squared over 2 times ln of x minus v du. Well, remember the v was x squared over 2, and the du was 1 over x dx. Now this may look a little complicated, but notice that x squared and x here, we have some cancellation. So this integrand is really just x over 2. So when we go ahead and take the antiderivative of x over 2, well, that means we're going to get, for the antiderivative of x is x squared over 2, and then we divide by 2, that just gives us x squared over 4. So my antiderivative in this case is x squared over 2 times ln of x, which came from our uv. And then when I did the antiderivative of the v du, I got x squared over 4, and that's subtracted. And then I always get my plus c when I do an antiderivative.